invite you to engage with us in a no-nonsense advocacy of the need for unity of international action and sincere commitment of all concerned partners, both in governments and beyond, in our struggle to defeat slavery once and for all. We believe that your honest and courageous voice is going to be an indispensable asset to this collective effort. On a more personal note, I cannot but marvel at how your and Amal's first names mean the very same thing, hope. As a firm believer in the higher meaning of life's apparent coincidences, I would like you to know that both of you, give us hope. Thank you.
Bonjour, mes chers amis. I'd like to start by thanking UNODC and the Permanent Mission of the United States for organizing this important ceremony. With a special word of appreciation to the Secretary General, to Ambassador Samantha Power, and to Madame Amal Clooney for their commitment and very powerful words. Ambassador Murad, chère Nadia, my French accent. On behalf of France, I want to express my warmest congratulations on your appointment as goodwill ambassador for the dignity of survivors of human trafficking. It means the world to all those who know you and believe in the UN. Your fight is our fight. I will never forget your very moving and inspiring words to the Security Council in December 2016, denouncing the trafficking committed by ISIS that you experienced in your flesh and blood, like hundreds of other Yazidi women, mothers, sisters, little girls, whom we found on the market of Raqqa, with price tags on them exhibited as mere consumer goods. This trafficking that we all know directly funds international terrorism and its sheer atrocities. When you spoke here, Nadia, there was not a dry eye in the room. Today, our moral and political responsibility is to transform this emotion, this huge emotion, into action. Not words, action. Because your fight is an existential fight for the Yazidi people, but also for all of us, and frankly, for the United Nations. France is and will be at the forefront of this international fight to stop human trafficking, to stop its related violations such as slavery, forced labor, sex work, to protect victims, but also to prosecute perpetrators. And precisely to prosecute perpetrators efficiently and systematically day after day, wherever they are, we must use all available means, whether through international justice systems or by encouraging national efforts. And that's why, chère Madame Clooney, your call and proposals are so critically important. And this is what this meeting, frankly, is all about. To honor you, Nadia, for sure, but also to be inspired by your extraordinary example and commitment to stand up against genocide and mass atrocities and to better combat impunity and terrorism.
Especially women and children, and for all the advice Thank you very much. Cutting to the chase, I want to pay tribute to you, Nadia, for your bravery, your leadership, and your appointment today as UN Goodwill Ambassador. In my job, words matter, but sometimes even diplomats are lost for words. And when faced with the horror and brutality of Daesh, sometimes the words that we find ring hollow. The comfort of the Security Council chamber, the polished halls of the United Nations, they are a world away from the harsh realities that we seek to describe, a world away from the injustices we seek to overcome. And that is why it is so important that we hear your words, Nadia, the way you spoke them, with authority, credibility, and conviction about the wrongs that you suffered. It was no surprise that when you addressed the UN Security Council, the world listened to a brave young woman who had endured so much, who had lost so much, but who told ultimately a story of survival, of hope, of overcoming the unspeakable. It's a story I've used in my own speeches. When I found myself lost for words, I have used Nadia's. And it's now a story that needs a just and swift conclusion. That's why the United Kingdom is playing a leading role in the global coalition to defeat Daesh. It's why the United Kingdom is committed to tackle modern day slavery wherever it appears. And it's why we will lead a global campaign to bring Daesh to justice. On Monday, the United Kingdom will host with the governments of Iraq and Belgium a meeting to begin that campaign. And I'm delighted that the UN's newest Goodwill Ambassador will be there to add her powerful voice to that effort. Thank you, Nadia, for sharing your story with the world and for all your work helping survivors.
Thank you very much. Congratulations, Nadia. I feel honored and humbled to have a colleague as you, honestly. And it was very difficult to forget your intervention in December. It is going to be even more difficult to forget your words today. With your strength, you're moving the international community to take decisive actions. And that is very important. I would like to thank the Office on Drugs and Crime. I would like to thank the US mission. And I would like to thank Amal Clooney for your commitment and for your moving words. Spain is going to preside the Security Council in December. And I would like to reconfirm that we are going to organize a session on human trafficking. Tragically, today ISIL and Boko Haram both openly advocate the enslavement of women and children. Human trafficking is modern slavery. It is a crime against humanity. It is time to join forces. Let us not forget Nadia's horrendous experience and use the strength. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ambassador. The Security Council asked us in December of 2015 to come back in 12 months with a report on what the UN is doing on human trafficking and how we can better work on this issue. And it is heartening that that will come up before your presidency in December. And I say heartening because if you're there, there will be hard in that Security Council meeting. And now I call on the permanent representative of Iraq, who we are so honored to have with us here today. Ambassador, you have the floor.
شكرا جزيلا للبداية السيد الأمين العام السيد رئيس الجمعية العامة الزميلة سفيرة الولايات المتحدة أحيي أيضا الأمير تحسين سعيد علي أمير اليزيديين في العراق والعالم ورئيس مجلس الروحاني اليزيدي الأعلى وكذلك أحيي سماحة باب الشيخ عضو المجلس الروحاني الأعلى أحيي عوائل الشهداء والمفقودين السفيرة نادية مراد والسيدة البارستا المفقودة.
I'm extremely pleased to be here with you to participate in the appointment ceremony of Ms. Nadia Murad as a Goodwill Ambassador for Dignity of Survivors of Human Trafficking. Nadia is an Iraqi Yazidi woman who had suffered grave abuses at the hand of members of Daesh terrorist group. Nadia traveled around the world meeting leaders, dignitaries, UN agencies, civil society groups, and to tell her story of horror and mass atrocities committed by a bunch of thugs and criminals belong to a non-Islamic group. We are proud of the strength, commitment, and devotion of Nadia. Possesses to tell her horrific story to the world and let the world know clearly the type of criminals that we are in. Iraq is proud of Nadia and will work with the international communities to defeat Daesh, rebuild villages and towns, support survivors, and invest in community rebuilding, not forgetting to take the severest punishment against those who have committed those atrocities. On behalf of the Iraqi government, I thank the Secretary General, Ban Ki-moon, and UNODC for nominating Nadia Murad as a Goodwill Ambassador. Goodwill Ambassador Nadia Murad will be the best UN Goodwill Ambassador for Dignity of Survival of Human Trafficking. Iraq and the international community entrust her with this mission, and we will wish her all success.